How are we doing? All right. Good evening. And man, all of a sudden, just like that, practice one's over. So it was a great day out there, as first practices always are. Full of energy, full of excitement. You know, this came on fast, and the practice went fast. Really, really clean. I was, you know, proud of our coaches and staff, and as well as our players, just for really understanding kind of the things we were trying to accomplish today. You know, not just the execution of the football field, you know, when it came to running our concepts and our plays, but also just, you know, the transitions. You know, it's new for everyone. And the guys, I thought, just did a great job. You can see the want to, the desire, you know, is there through the effort that they gave. And just really, really, I really thought it came together in a nice way. They protected each other, which is a big thing when it comes to our practice habits. And, you know, we want to be healthy and be able to improve every play. And you got to be able to, the only way to prove is by being out there. So, you know, I think that's one of the key things in doing what we're doing all spring long, is just being really intentional what we're doing, whether it's building relationships or how we practice, creating those habits that are what we call championship habits. And I think they did a really nice job with that today. So, I'll open up for questions.
Coach,
starting your left with Chase.
Yep.
Coach, the NCAA, is the rules committee, is going to be instituting this helmet communication between coaches and players apparently this fall. Just a two-part question about that. One, just your general thoughts on what kind of a game changer that might be. And two, is that something that you could test out this spring just to give quarterbacks an early feel for it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we were doing it today. So we had it out there, and I didn't. We had, you know, with supply and demand across the country, you know, we aren't able to have as many as what the max would be. But we had a couple quarterbacks, and, you know, with that in, and, you know, I haven't heard any feedback yet. I think early on it was a couple times it was maybe a little hard to hear one way or another. I don't think it was because it was too soft. I think it was actually because it was too loud. But I'm sure that will get tested in our stadium at some point. But just, you know, I think there's a lot of reasons for it, you know, that I know can be positive. I don't know if it answers all the concerns that you might have when it comes to, I think, some of the things people will say it automatically fixes, and, you know, maybe sign stealing and things like that. So, because I think there's other ways where it could go the other way. With being intentional and trying to get a call and being able to echo it through your defensive headset, and you know, it could go on and on with that. But it was good. I think you know, the quarterbacks just getting used to it. I saw them a couple of times, you know, putting their hand up to their helmet, just listening. But for the most part, it seemed pretty clean.
We'll go in the middle with Michael Casagrande.
So you've been here a month and a half now. What surprised you most about taking this job, getting off this plane? You know, what did you not expect when you got here?
Well, I don't know if it's not that I didn't expect it. The thing I want to give our guys props for is just how open they've been to everything that we've asked them to do. You know, so it doesn't surprise me. You know, just they've embraced, you know, all the little differences and nuances that different personalities bring, you know, just different ideas that we have. You know, and it's just been really smooth, and it's a huge credit to our guys, and I think our staff's done a really good job of being aligned and on the same page and being organized to where it's very clear, concise, and the expectations are something that the guys can easily understand.
We're on the right with Charlie.
Hey, Coach. I wanted to ask you, go back a little bit and ask you about the fourth quarter program. Just what were your impressions of that, and maybe did you add any wrinkles or tweak that at all?
No, we kept it pretty consistent with what it's been. And the guys, you know, you can tell it's something that they really feel strong about. The energy just is there, you know, from the beginning to the end. And I think the key is, right, is taking that in the workouts when we're in the early winter months here and transferring that over to football. And that was the challenge today. We have a period at the end where we gather and we refer to it, I've done this many years now, refer to it as also the finish or fourth quarter period. And, you know, being able to connect to what they just did the last few weeks with the fourth quarter program, you know, it's transferring it from the indoor and the workouts that they're doing onto the football field. I think that excites them. And, you know, there's been a lot of football games won because of the work that's been put in because of that program, and you know, they believe in it. You know, and it's going to be important for us this fall for sure.
Obviously, a big part of spring practice is the player development from the first practice to last practice. But what are you looking for out of your coaching staff in terms of, you know, where they can grow from practice one to practice 15?
Well, I told the guys, the players, you know, they're excited to watch their own film now because, you know, when you bring in the concepts, whether it's offense, defense, special teams, the coaching staff brings in your ideas, which usually involve cut-ups that are from the programs you come from. And so I just told the players when we broke down that we get to watch some of their film, which I know they're all excited to do. And, you know, from a coaching standpoint, to me, there's a lot of pieces to our job, but right now it's for us to give them feedback. So they need feedback on everything that happened, you know, the grading of every play and giving the feedback, you know, to our guys, and so they can understand, you know, whether it's that play or that practice, you know, or the session that we were in, whether, you know, it was a 7-on-7 period or a team period, even individual, you know, why did this drill go well, and giving feedback all the time. That's a big priority for us as a coaching staff, so that way the guys can continue to understand the expectations, continue to improve. We have maxims we refer to, and one of our maxims is to have a relentless pursuit of continuous improvement. And we don't take any of those words lightly, from relentless all the way to pursuit of improvement. And, you know, that's the thing I'll ask our guys tomorrow when we get together and kind of review the practice. Was that the mindset, and was that clear from the beginning to the end?
Stay on the right with Nick.
You had a chance to bring in Keon Sab recently. What about him was attractive about bringing him in? And also, what kind of role do you envision for a guy like that?
Yeah, I mean, you bring a guy like him in to be an impact player for you. And his experiences, you know, not just, you know, each and every play, but also the experiences and leadership that as he's here longer and longer that we would expect from him because of, you know, the level that he took his team to, winning a championship. You know, that fits in well with what we're trying to accomplish and what we're trying to do. And just the character makeup, aside from, of course, what we know is a great football player, he just is a really good fit for us. It's been a pleasure getting to know him more and more each and every day, just seeing how he's operating. And, you know, right now he's just going about his work, but you can tell he's got that it factor. He's got the leadership piece within him to where I know we'll be counting on him this fall.
You talked in your opening about the championship habits and then recently about the maxims. Are those the same thing, or kind of what are some of the pillars that you like to build your programs on?
Yeah, yeah, it is. It's we have the maxims to refer to them, and number one is winners win, because that's what winners do. And winning, I know that's a results-oriented kind of piece to it, but what we really focus on is what the winners do. And the winners in our program have an attention to detail. You know, they compete, and we go on and on. We have a list of those things, that the habits they create each and every day will lead to the winning aspect. And we're never going to shy away from that being really important here at Alabama. The second one is first be your best, and then you'll be first. And you know, in there, it's be your best. And when you just bring your best energy, attitude, and effort every day, and that's the number one thing and the only thing we really ask of our guys, and the rest takes care of itself. When we do that, good things are going to happen, especially when you have the talent, when you have the coaching and the skill by the players that are within this program. Good things are going to happen. And then in order to be your best, you have to have the relentless pursuit of continuous improvement that I referred to.
Through your career, have you developed kind of like benchmarks you're looking the team to hit, either chemistry or on the field wise, you know, through a spring, and that specifically the first spring?
Yeah. I think every year is different, and you have to start over from scratch. If this is year two for me here, I would still go back to the bare bones of setting down the expectations, because, you know, we're around 30 new players that are here in the program, and with that, you know, you have to talk about, you know, what's the tempo that we're operating with practice with when we're helmets and spider pads? What is it when we're helmets and shoulder pads? What is it when we're full pads? You have to go back to those detailed conversations and lay out the expectations in a way where everyone's on the same page, because there's guys that took their first snaps, as a college football player here. I understand some of these guys, and a lot of these guys did do some things during the bowl season as early enrollees, but we would start over from scratch, and we would be, again, intentional on, you know, our communication as coaches. We would be intentional what we're asking, and the new leaders that are having to step up, they may have been leaders before, but there's a new dynamic that takes place, because there are some guys that are gone that were pretty integral pieces to not just the production, but leading this football team last year. So it all starts over, whether it's first year or second year or third year, it all starts over.
Yeah, kind of on that. Is it a clean slate with your players, and have you conveyed that to them? Is that kind of the message that you're sending? Is everything's a clean slate, and we're going to work from here?
Yeah, I don't know if I've really said it in those terms, but the others. I mean, you know, you're gathering information every day, right? I'm getting to know them. They're getting to know myself and the staff, and so those first impressions, I know we're important for those guys as they're out there today competing and going making plays and. The intensity was high, and I would expect it to be that as they, like you said, you know, have kind of a new slate, and everyone's starting from the same point.
Coach, kind of touched on that. You talk about depth chart and different stuff. Obviously, I'm not asking for a depth chart, but you have players. I mean, you sat next to Jalen Milroe at the basketball game. Is that your guy going into it, or do you clean slate every year with every position?
Yeah, I mean, you want competition, right? And so the competition is always going to be there, and yeah, someone had to take the first reps today, you know, with the ones when we lined up and we referred to him as that, and Jalen did, you know. So, he's putting everything into it he can, along with the other guys that took those first reps. But I fully expect those guys that are really hungry to be pushing those guys that are ahead of them to be their best. And that's what you want in a football program. And that's certainly going to be the case here with so many good football players here wanting to get on the football field.
In the back, two more. Coach, you mentioned that this is a new territory, new waters for everybody. With the players and interactions with your new coaching staff, what was your first overall impressions of them today at practice?
Yeah, I think they really take coaching well. We have specific jobs that we call them, or descriptions of what the coach's jobs and players' job are, and we're very, intentional. Said that word a lot, but we talk about the coach's jobs being to teach, critique, and demand, and we really talk about the critique part and the demanding part, and so when we're pushing a guy and we're asking more out of him, when we're coaching him up, that's a good thing, because that means we care and we see that potential in them, and that's our job. So I think the guys just really see that and could feel it today. And from a player standpoint, it's to continue to grind and continue to refine what they do and compete each and every play.
Okay, we're gonna finish up here with Matt. I know I didn't get everybody, but we'll get you next time.
How much of today, I guess, how smooth was it seeing the, just for players, like learning how practices work now, just where drills are and all of that?
Yeah, we talked through the last week a few different times just on where these locations are for each session. And, it was actually pretty smooth. The guys, had a pretty good feel of where to go. And, what it allows you to do is then have the expectation of hustling and having a bounce in your step. And the energy never fell off the entire length of practice. So I think, when it comes to execution, as far as just how smooth things were, I think practice one is pretty easy. It's your base stuff on each side of the ball. I think, where it will get hard is when we get into each continual install, practice two, but then especially practice three and four and five, as we continue to put more in offensively or defensively, and then the other side of the ball is actually putting something in as well. And that's when it becomes something where not just what you have to do, but also what you're going against across from you. So, today was great. I thought it was smooth from transitions to just how hard we competed and guys stayed up, and again, that helps with our health. And I thought the execution actually was pretty good. It's going to be a give and take. That's what you want from the head coach's standpoint. The offensive guys, of course, want to dominate, and the defensive guys want to dominate each and every play. But from my standpoint, I want to see that good give and take, and that was certainly the case today.
All right, Coach, thank you.
All right, thank you. Roll Tide.